So, ang first is, meaning ng tamudaan, ng pag-financial statement audit, the first stage yun, is before you perform the audit, you need to perform the pre-engagement activities. So, dili lang basta dawat ng dawat, abi pa lang, dali na tamudaan, naatayin mo on. So, this pre-engagement activities usually is not only applicable to audit engagements, it's also applicable to other engagements of a CPA. Abot lang sa open profession, pero dapat i-perform niya. So, what is the goal of pre-engagement activities? The first one, sa pre-engagement pagod, you need to answer two questions. Are you capable? Na. So, in answering that first question, this talks about your resources. Resources, availability. So, when there is a client, like for example, magpa-audit siya, you need to check if you have resources na available. For example, kung dako kayo ang isa ka engagement, it needs a lot of people to perform. So, do you have human resources? You check na nimo. Pag naa naman, you need to check the time. Because sometimes, ang mga engagement na deadline, nga, makaya ninyo. So, that's another question, if you'll be able to meet the time or the deadline. The next is, sometimes, the client will not pay you anything pa. So, whenever you audit, like for example, if it is a big company, you need to pay for some things sa audit engagement. So, ikaw pa yung sa loob. So, included in your resources is if nakay enough money to perform the engagement. Although, it will always be reimbursed by the client. But, as of now, kung kinahanglan ba, ikaw mo yung magastos una, can you do it? So, mo na ang pinakauna na question. Pero naman ikaw question yun. Are you capable? And, do your prospective client na ba siya'y integrity? So, tawagin na ito, client's integrity. Okay? So, again, are you capable? Do you have available resources? So, human resources, time, and money. Now, aside from those resources, confident ba ka that you'll be able to follow the ethical requirements sa isang ka-engagement? So, lang ang ethical requirements that we need to follow. We have what do we call as code of ethics. So, dito ni naka-center, but as early as now, kinahanglan na natin istoryahan ang ethical requirements that are necessary. So, when performing an audit, which is an assurance engagement, kinahanglan daw ni Mone yun ang mga ethical requirements. So, PCOPIC. So, the first one is professional competence. So, did you attain the professional competence? Are you confident that if you are going to accept such engagement, confident pa ba ka that you are competitive with other professionals in the field? So, professional competence. Actually, in the Code of Ethics, it's composed of two stages. The first one, stage one, is attainment of competence. So, unsa man yung attainment of competence? This happens if you pass the CPA board examination. So, in that particular stage, dating na nimong competence. Ang ikaduha, maintenance of professional competence. So, pag muingon tag maintenance of professional competence, this talks about, una, are you attending seminars? in order for you to update yourself with the new standards and the new rules in the practice of accounting. So kaya nag-audit makadali, are you attending seminars related to your field or any other field as a certified public accountant? So maintenance na siya, professional competence. Are you pursuing your master's degree or doctorate degree? So that's still maintenance of professional competence. And there are a lot more. Are you in speaking engagements? Like mag-speaker ka sa isa ka seminar? Makakuha na siya. Maintenance of professional competence. Now, with regards to this specific audit engagement, ang professional competence na ginasabot diri, ginapasabot diri, is not only the stage 1 and the stage 2. Included sa diri, if you have knowledge on the audit client, audit clients, what do you call this? Line of business or industry. So, if bago pa ka sa field, of course, you will be able to perform simple na mga audits ng gagmay na companies like merchandising companies, manufacturing, because we are taught on how to do that. Tapos nagkuha pag yung meaningful experience para maka-audit ka. So you know how to audit a merchandising and manufacturing entities na binag-servicing. Pero when we talk about complicated industries, like for example, mining industries, agoy, ayaw yun, audit-audit o mining company na wala kay kuan experience and technical skills. So actually, according to the standard, pwede ba ka muna? What good? Bahalag wala pa kay experience sa isa ka audit client, like nai nagpa-audit, pero baka naka-audit o ginana. Basta kay you are confident that you'll be able to get the necessary skills and knowledge during the audit. Pero kanang lisod na good gaayo i-attain during the audit na skills and knowledge, ayaw na dawata because you are not competent enough to do that. Ang akong example is ang mining company. Na mining company, kalisudan na, you will not be able to attain the competence necessary to audit the mining company during the duration sa inyong engagement. It's impossible. So, muna yung pasabot na professional competence. So, again, aside from the resources availability, kay kinahanglan man nimo ikuan, i-ask, are you capable of doing the engagement? So, aside from this, you need to be able na ma-confident that you'll be able to maintain, to start, during, and ending. Ma-maintain nini mo ng ethical requirements. Because if not, don't accept such engagement. So, next, we have integrity. Na, so, can you be able to maintain your integrity? So, integrity is being true, being honest. Na, being honest. Walang integrity. So, normally, a CPA should be honest sa mga undertaking. Like, dili mag-make ng mga exaggerated na claims, mga ilad-ilad, because dapat as a profession that has been accepted by the society and the public, or the society places their public trust, kinahanglan honest yun ta. So that's what do we call as integrity. And even if we are honest, can we maintain this principle, confidentiality principle, that whatever it is na imong malearn sa audit client, dili nimo sa isaba sa lain? So, kining confidentiality is very important. So, what are the challenges sa confidentiality? Example, CPA ka, tapos nasa kay business, unya, ang imog yung direct competitor ni Dool sa imo kaysa kay CPA ka, pero na kay business. Direct competitor ang ni Dool sa imo magpa-audit. So that means, na kay conflict of interest kay whatever it is na malearn ni mo sa iyang company, sigurado ko that will affect your company also and you will be violating the confidentiality. Or else, ang mga magkaaway na companies, ikaw ang auditor, okay. It's very difficult to maintain that confidentiality. So, if ever na yung mga challenges na yung anak, it's better na dili na lang mo siya i-accept. Pero na may mga safeguards and you will know that later sa code of ethics. But, mo na yung pasabot sa confidentiality. So, you cannot tell anyone, even your parents, even your family, about anything sa audit client pag-audit ni mo. Except for this cases, naani siya yung exceptions ng confidentiality. Now, kining sa exceptions, huwag ka na ka. Huwag ka na. So, ang exceptions is, kining sa exceptions, pwede na ka mutabing sa unsay mong hibalan with regard sa client. Ano sa man eh? Una, court case. So, if ever your audit client and you as the auditor nag-away, nagamit sa court, kay ipasanginlan ka sa imong client that you did not do your engagement well. So, nag-audit ka, huwag ka magtarong sa tingin na, or any engagement at all. Siyempre, in order to defend yourself, no, to defend yourself against lawsuit, ang maghatag yung mga ebidensya na nagtarong ka and you perform the audit based on Philippine standards in auditing. So, pwede na nimo i-disclose sa court, pakita nimo ang mga papil-papil sa imong pag-audit. So, that's the first exception. Hinahangla nimo, siyempre, defend yourself against lawsuit. So that's the first exception. Dili pwede na ka mag-disclose. Ang ikaduha, if gi-issuehan kang subpoena, guys, like na ay kaso si kliyente, pero dili ikaw ang kalaban ni kliyente, instead na yung other persons. And kung gikasuhan ang kliyente, like for example, tax evasion, something na na yung client has been subjected to tax evasion case. And because of that, the court needed the files na naan sa imo, sa imong audit. Na imo yun ang isubmit, guys, ng mga files. Basing makasuhan ka na, hindi mo ipanghatag, eh, you are adhering to confidentiality principle. Tapos you are hindering the investigation. Sus, patay. So, itawag na, mga kaso. Kanaganing imong ipanalipdan mo ng hili ka kung ano? Kalimong pangko? Basta, naikaso na. Kalimot ko. Basta kasuhan ka, pag magpadili-dili ka, kasuhan ka, kung imong gitago ang kriminal, something ina na. So, kining pagtagaan ka sa FINA, ihatag ka lang mga files. Ayun ang pagpagali-gali. Okay? Next, so, ang next na exception, aside sa tagaan kang sabina, na pwede nimo masulti ang details about the client na imong i-audit or any engagement at all, basta kayo na kay client, is when the BOA requires or the Board of Accountancy. Ano sa madali, sir? Kanang Board of Accountancy, mauna yung nag-regulate sa education, sa examination, and practice of accountancy here in the Philippines. So, sa practice, tadapit. So, sa practice, kining BOA, mag-inistrikto niyo sa hayang ipang-check ang mga public practitioners kung nagtarong ba sa ilang mga services. So, audit-audit ni sila. Like for example, nagtukod na kag-office, ayaw katingala, nanay mo anha na taga-BOA. na i-check ang imuhang mga papeles kung gisakto ba nimo pag-audit, gisakto ba nimo pag-compilation, agreed upon procedures, review financial statements, and a lot more. Kasi syempre, gusto nila high ang quality ng services that will be performed sa public. So, pag si Boa, mayingon, asa man imong mga working papers or mga documents na imuhang nahimo in performing the engagement. Ayata, pwede ra pa-violate ang confidentiality principle or bisang pag naaling tulo, di pa-violate ang confidentiality principle. Now, lastly, you can violate the confidentiality principle, kini may pinakagana, when client permits. Oh, punta na ka sa client. Pwede naman ihatag. Sige, ihatag. So, the client permitted you to disclose such information, so it's fine. You did not violate the confidentiality na ethical requirement. Nag-gets? So, mo lang confidentiality, mo lang i-maintain. And we have, kinahanglan mo na i-maintain at the start, during, and at the end of the engagement, pati gani beyond. Kung gusto pa nimo na mahimo gihapon auditor ng kanang audit line, you need to maintain this objectivity. Kung sabi ni objectivity, not biased. Being objective is not being biased. Based on evidence. Paon ang objectivity? Not biased. Your opinion or your statements are based on evidence or evidences, and you are free from conflict of interest. In short, muna kag walang kinikilingan din eh. Walang pinuprotektahan, walang kasinungalingan, ambisyong totoo lamang. Muna siya. So not biased. That means there are no parties na imong ipiguran. Like when you audit, even if the accountant seems like your future na kay guwapa kaayo, dili mo siya dili mo siya tagaan o favor. You need to be objective. So not biased. And when you say something, statement, it should be based on evidences. That's being objective. And you should be free from conflict of interest. So those are the two terms for objectivity. So free from conflict of interest, meaning dili pwede na kitahay ikaw may mag-audit sa company sa imuhang manghod because you will not be able to be na mahimo kang objective because there is a conflict of interest. So, muna siya. Di ka pwede mag-audit sa company ng imong company. Kay imo na ganin ng company ang tag-iya na imong company. Ikaw ang tag-iya po na basically. So, there is a conflict of interest. You cannot audit your competitor because that is a conflict of interest. Lahi ang imong interest, dili ang pag-audit. Instead, po siya kay mga sekreto na mas nakulungin is nag-seal sa ako. Nag-gets ba? Daghan kang ma-violate. So those are the two terms na maglibog na pausaya ang mga estudyante how integrity and objectivity differs. So these are the two terms for objectivity. And we have professional behavior. So kini siya is behaving like a professional or para mas social siya. So you are behaving in a way that is not discreditable sa profession. Like, di madamay ang profession sa imong behavior ba? For example, naman to'y balita ko na nainadakpan na CPA kay nag-drugs. Dari naman to. O kato siya, is a violation of professional behavior. Nadamay kay i-appeal sa radyo. Ay CPA, na anak sa doktor, anak. Na prison, I don't remember kung ano sa. So, kung ikaw, masipay ka, bawal na ka maghubog-hubog, tas mo ambak sa boulevard. Tapos mabalita, Oy, naay CPA ni ambak sa Bolivar kay nahubog na kayo. Dili na pwede. You need to adhere to professional behavior. So ang last kay kuhan man lagi ni assurance engagement, kay kung dili assurance engagement, dili na tama sa pick-up ra ang imuhang i-perform. Like for example, you're performing tax services, you need to adhere sa kining lima, because tax services is non-assurance engagements. You're not expected to give an opinion about the subject matter. Pero again, if ever it's an assurance engagement na yung financial statement audit naman talon, mo nang you need to adhere to independence, which is composed of independence in fact or mind, independence in mind and independence in, sa tuwita ba? Independence in mind, independence in appearance, na dapat check ning duha in order to be considered as independent. So, kaming sa appearance, ako ganun na example, if ever na ikapalibo na kong apelido guys, na ikasama industry siya. Niya, layo na gid kay ko na ikasama ba. Pero auditor ko, wag yung pulos ng ang audit report, signed ba yan ikasama, tapos ang company nakapangalan po siya ikasama, bagsak siya sa appearance. So, dapat dili daw na pwede. So, dapat you're independent in fact, or independent in mind, as well as independent in appearance. So, muna siya guys, ang sa first question ka, are you capable? You have enough resources, and are you confident that you can maintain these ethical requirements during, at the start, ending, and beyond, if ever gusto pa niyo mag-auditor sa kana na engagement? So, if the answer is yes, then you go to the next question. Ang client ba na integrity? So, meaning, integrity ba? Integrity, di ba, is honest. So, client ba is honest. So, I have a lot of experiences about this. So, kung ato siyang kumpay, such, kung ang client mo na yung mga illegal activities, like for example, ang sa babaw is hotel, pero ang sa upos na ito, okay, ang first floor, sabungan na illegal, sabungan sa mga iro, sabungan sa mga iro, tapos next floor sa upos, ka ng balikianan o illegal na organs. O kana sa wala gyud na integrity na client, stay away. Nagets ba? Ayaw na. Or else, na inagpa kuhan sa imuha ng mga illegal na mga businesses, bagsak na siya sa integrity. Pero dili man inanagin ang mga normal kay kabalo ng mga tadayon, wala na sila integrity. Ang normal is na yung mga client na panabahuon ka, unya no na nadili magbayad. Mauna ang pinakapangit na kliyente. So, dapat yun, imo sang i-check kung na ba integrity ang client, di bayad ba ni, di ba illegal ang business. Because, if you're not careful, and if your name will be connected to those clients without integrity, your integrity will also be affected. Nagets ba? So, for example, ay si Sir Glitz, kung man si Sir Glitz, auditor man sa ubo-ubo, okay, ubo-ubo na illegal, at dili pwede. Nagets? Okay, wala isa na akong audience. Wala.
Yes!
So, yes. So, mauna sa client's integrity. The question is, how are you going to know kung nabay integrity ng kliyente? So, dili ah, syempre, di ba nilisod kay are you capable? Naman, sa imong self, di ba? Pero dili ah, how do you know if the client has integrity or wala? So, ang pinaka-main source of information about client's integrity is the predecessor. Predecessor auditor. Isang ning predecessor auditor. Ang kanay mong gisundan ba na auditor? Ang ilang past na auditor? So, kung predecessor auditor ka, ang tawag sa imuha guys is, so may tawag yun mo, successor auditor. Tapos, kung ikaw ang sa una, niya ikaw po lang karon, ang tawag sa'yo mo, continuing auditor. So, dili ka continuing auditor, syempre. Okay, kung continuing auditor ka, pangatanan din yung mong sarili. Meaning, successor auditor ka na kay predecessor auditor. So, you're going to ask the predecessor auditor, ano yung mga maning gibuhian na client? Mga minanak ba? Sabihin niyo, ibang pangutana sa iya, ha? Reasons. Why? Akapoy na pag-English, guys. Kini lang. Gibuhian niyo siya. Na, reasons. Ano, gibuhian niyo siya. Wala na yung pangutana, guys. Ayaw, atuwa si predecessor ko dito na. Ay, predecessor dito. Ang bigan na ito yung mga working papers kay. Bawalas ito akong basihan ka ron. Ayaw, pagaling ka ni dawat sa engagement. Ang kapal ng face ni mo. Bamaya kong tunay mo na dito. Ang imo lang yung pangutana din sa pre-engagement. Nga naman, ganong, di naman ikaw ang auditor. Ganong ako naman. Nagets ba? And, syempre, sa pinina question, pwede na yung mga valid na mga i-answer si predecessor. So meaning, isang pag may mong si predecessor na, ay, nag-relocate, mag-good-good, dilin ako sa Surigao, nag-balis ko sa Manila. So, ang akong gina-attender ka doon, ang ako ang new clients from Manila. So, imposible na mag-audit pa ko sa Surigao. So, that's a valid reason. Tapos, ang integrity ng client, di na mabuak sa iyong pananaw. Valid mo na reason nga nung gibuhian. Or else, may mga dugay na mugay ko na auditor, kuha na 20 years. So, it's time to move on. Ano? Something inana. Mga valid na, na reasons. Or else, wala mo nag-audit, wala mo nagkuha. Wala mo nag-renew sa ako ang kanang registration as an auditor kay ng business na mga kakapoy naman si audit ko. Kana, mga valid reasons na. Pero kung mga reasons, kay gahit nag-ulo ng kliyente, labi na nailangan ko ang accountant, top 2 mo na lang sa board exam. Kung nang dili mamating sa ako as an auditor, papag-inaan na, guys. Muna-una na ka. Nabay integrity ng kliyente, ha? Di ba? So, kana, dumalay mo yung pangutan na. Disagreements, if ever, and the reason na nung nagbuwa si predecessor auditor o si client. Sa mahayong ko, bumuton ba or dili? Now, si predecessor auditor is also adhering to these ethical requirements. So it so he is or she is also adhering to confidentiality principle. Wala yung problema. Kaya pwede na niya dili disclose. So ang imong himo na successful auditor, pangutana nimo si client, pwede ba mag-ikstorya ko sa predecessor auditor kay part man siya sa process. Pag may mong si client na, oh, sige, sige. But the client permits. Oh, sugod man si client. Di, pwede na ito i-disclose ni predecessor auditor. Now, what if wa ni sugod ang client? Normally, magduda na ka na wala siguro na integrity na hindi natago ni nga nung nag-ilis siya o auditor. Wa na itong predecessor auditor kasi wa ni magbayad or something na na. So, pag na kay duda, of course, mahimuha na tayo mong paagi kung hain ka mangita o mga ebidensya kung nabasay kuan kanang tinatago or wala para makitaan yun mo ang integridad niya. So, pag-check po ni ang client's integrity, ibayad, pag-scrutiny mo sa predecessor auditor, ang reasons na ibuhian is valid, walay disagreements, and etc. Then check ang client's integrity, pero kung di gihapon ka satisfied, kiwa ka subti, you can perform other measures para ma-check ang integrity ni client. But pag dili manggod, normally si client mo subot na mo-ato ka sa predecessor auditor na is something wrong yun, ano. So, mo na yung duha sa pre-engagement na yung i-perform. So, pag-check ng duha again, you need to make an engagement letter na. Pirma, doon yung duha. So, maling engagement letter, mura ni contract ng services ni mo. So, ang nakabutang dali normally, services offered ni mo para kang client, pati ang expected outputs and deadlines. Na para klaro kung unsa ray expected of you as well as the deadlines if ever. Now, pwede butang dali ang payment style or ang payment scheme. Kung sa may payment scheme sa imo as an auditor, na mag-way flat rate, like pag mag-audit ng bagong financial statements, 100,000 yun na ako mag-audit. So, flat rate, ibutang ko liya. Or pwede ba monthly? So muna sa si tawagan na. Basta monthly, regularly, per period. Or pwede cost plus markup. Depende na na. Ang bawal sa audit is ang what do we call as contingent fees. So, note 3, bawal contingent fees. Sa mga assurance engagements, labot ni, labi na sa audit. Pero sa uban na mga engagement, pwede yung contingent fees. Kasi may contingent fees. Fees based on results of audit, for example. Example na na, ha? Example, ngayon ang client na, sige sir, pag ang financial statements, unmodified di mong opinion, aminin mo muna unmodified, walang problema, free from material misstatements, fairly stated siya. Pag unmodified, tagaan takag balay sa Siargao, thousand lang, dole sa beach. Pero pag dili, tagaan takag 2,000. Kaya sa is a contingent fee. Because that fee is based on the results of the audit or based on a specific outcome. Dili na pwede. Kaya dapat yung opinion is not biased, independent. Siyempre, pagtagaan ka ginato na offer, i-unmodified mo na lang. Kasi siyempre, gusto yun na yung balay sa Siargao na doon sa beach. So, self-interest threat ng contingent fees. Kaya mo nabag, kada na bayad dahil sa Siargao. Makita na ko si Andy. O si, kita tong, si Baktos-Baktos mo tiniin? Si Nadine Lustre. Di. Imo na lang yan, qualified. Di na ka mag-audit. Diretso na kag-print. O unmodified opinion. So give me the beach house. So, bawal ang contingent fees. But katong uban, like, fees based on experience sa nag-audit or educational attainment, pwede na silang tanan. Basta di lang fees based sa outcome. Pero again, sa uban engagement, pwede ng contingent fees. Like for example, nag-prepare ka tax returns, tapos na yun ang kliyente, pag naantay masib sa tax na ako, using tax avoidance, dili ng tax evasion, tax avoidance, tunga na, aking kapatid ka sa savings, o pwede na siya. So, paningkamutan mo, avoid. So, kung ang client mo naging tax na bayad nun na 1 million, ang yan napagamay ni mo guys of 10,000. So 990,000 divided by 2 mo. O kan na, pwede na. Kaya non-assurance engagement, you're not expected to give an independent opinion. So, bawal na siya ang sa fees. Ang bawal ipamuntang nari guys, is ka ng mga audit procedures na mo. Like for example, may ka day 1. Okay. Day 1, magpa-meeting. Day 2, mag-count sa petty cash. Okay, makaandam ng mga amaw sa imuhang himuon, kanang management. Dapat surprise na na imuhang procedures na imuhang gidesign. O sila, papalug yun. Although, you need their cooperation. Okay? So, yun, butang diha ang kuwari mo, audit procedures, bawal na bawal. Now, so that's it for engagement letter. That's an evidence that you have already accepted the engagement. And aside from being an evidence that you have accepted the engagement, it's a confirmation na nakasabot si client sa imong mga i-deliver. And if ever, it can also be used para ma-resolve ang conflicts ninyo ni client if ever. Kasi mag-away-away mo ba? So klaro sa audit engagement, unsa ray imuhang gipromise na mga services and outputs. So mao nang sa engagement letter. Now sir, permitted ba maghatag og engagement letter kung auditor ka karon nya mag-audit na buka sa ilaha, the same audit client next year? No. It is not necessary na mag-send ka og kanang bag-o na engagement letter unless dai change sa scope ng imong trabaho. Example, karon na year, review of financial statements ka. So, ang imong engagement letter karon na year, review. Nya next, gusto nila magpa-audit na. There is a change in scope sa imong trabahoon. Or else, natanggal ang mga importanteng tao sa imong kliyente na katulad ng mga kaistorya. nawala na ang mga board of directors ni mga istorya, ang CEO ni hawa na, and other people. There is a significant change in the environment of the client. At kinahanglan mo mag-send o bago na engagement letter. Or else, group of companies imong gina-audit. Ang sa una, ang kuan na, main office lang ipa-audit. Karon ipa-appeal na mga branches. You need to send another engagement letter for that. Again, if there is a change in scope of the work, as well as there is a significant change in the client's environment, you need to send another engagement letter. But if wala nang duha, then no need kung mag-continue na ka as an auditor to send an engagement letter. So that's it for pre-engagement activities. So again, pre-engagement activities, ha? Capable ba ka? Na by integrity si client.